All right, y'all. So Jenna and I showed you down here across the creek where we're going to put our garden this year. I brought the tractor down, finagled around, and finally got across the creek with it, with the bush hog. Just kind of cut some of those briars back a little bit, and just to give us a little bit more room, not to actually garden, but to get around the garden without getting in the blackberries and the wild roses, because they will eat you up. So kind of did some measuring as far as stepping off. We can do a garden, it can be 30 feet wide on this side. It can be 120 feet long. And on that side, it can be probably 45 feet wide. So what we're thinking about doing is it'll just till it, you know, to fit the space, and then running our rows this way. And as you can see, in the evening, we get some shade from the hill, the ridge right here behind y'all. Our house is up there. So it kind of gives us some shade, a nice time to come down and work the garden. Get a little bit of shade in the morning as the sun comes up over the ridge, but most all the day is this full sun. So shade in the morning and in the evening is a good thing for me, because I, you know, it's just a nice, peaceful, more cool time to work in your garden. But one of the things we've talked about is, you know, you don't want to try to jump across the creek or walk across the creek the whole time. So I was thinking we need to make a bridge, you know, a walking bridge to get across. We can bring our tractor down. Actually, Emma is videoing. She's sitting on the bush hog right now. But so the tractor's down here, and we have a little wagon that we pull behind it sometimes when we're fencing. It's just a little, like, it's technically a trailer, I guess. But we can bring the tractor down here, and but I don't want to cross the creek with it a bunch, because it'll just make a mud hole and I'll get stuck and have to dig my way out with the loader, and it's just, you know, it just takes a while. But so if we had a walking bridge, we could go across and harvest everything into, like, maybe one of those garden carts or something. We need to get one, but one of those garden carts or something, and then wheel it across the bridge to the tractor, load that stuff into the wagon. Now, this is us planning on having a nice harvest, you know. I'm forever optimistic, so trying to think of a good way to make a bridge just on the cheap with what I have, because it's what I have. And we've got about, it's probably about 10 feet across the creek. Not the creek is not that wide, but from bank to bank, 8 or 10 feet. We measured it earlier and I needed about 14 feet left to make a level bridge. Well, you know what I have is 14 feet long or even longer. And I have a bunch of them that I'm not using, gates. We have a 16-foot gate that Jack and I brought down here. We dragged it down with the tractor. And then we have this, don't we, Emma?
Yep.
A surplus of pallets. So this is an experiment, but I think I have a pretty good plan to make this work. You know, we might not all be able to get on this thing and jump up and down on it at the same time. But then again, it's going to be pretty strong, because it's only spanning a short distance. But this is an older gate. You know, the bottom of it's rusting out some, so it's not like it's a brand new nice gate. But it is a 16-foot gate. So here we go. We're going to try this. All right. Let's set it down, Jack. Just slide it. Come on up, up a little bit right in there. So we might have to wiggle it around to figure out a good level spot. Let me try this. That's pretty good right there. Okay. Now, let's see. Make sure it's not going to collapse with us. I'm definitely the heaviest person that'll be on this. 235-ish pounds. So it's holding us. Nobody else walk on it yet, okay? Not till we get the boards on it. So,
you want to side it that way?
I think I like it right here, Jack, but
fairly level as far as sitting goes, right? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Are you talking about sliding across the creek
like that? Yeah, towards.
Yeah, Jeremiah, pick it up and go your way a little bit with it. Y'all step off. Nobody walk on the gate stone. Straight. Straight forward. Pull it hard. There you go. A little bit more. A little bit more. A little bit more. Right there. I like that. Okay. So,
you know, it's going to be stronger too once we put the pallets on it. So what I'm going to do, my idea is anyway, to take these pallets and cut these off. So the actual pallet can sit down in the between the rails on the gate, and I'll probably have to cut a notch where the braces are, which would normally be the vertical braces on the gate. But let's see if this works, Jack. Let's try this. The idea of this is actually getting it to sit down in between, and I haven't even tried. I hope it hits right. It, you know, it might not even hit to fit between these. And then these will have a lot more support because the metal tubes on the gate are closer together than the 2x4s on here, so it'll make it even stronger, these pallets. So, let's see. That is going to work right there. So if we, let's see here. Let's see, what do I need to do here?
Is the shovel still down here?
It's on the bush hog.
Okay. Yeah, the shovel's down here. I'm looking at my, where I need to notch. Okay.
It's
all right.
Huh?
So, I'll notch this. Doesn't need much.
Yep. We're getting ready to have the moment of truth here.
And then was it like right here, the middle?
No, I think it was all the way. Well, it would have been, yeah, the middle, and then,
last one.
The last one.
You found the shell? Yeah.
Nice. What color is it?
I don't know. White. I'm pretty sure it's a white one.
Looks white to me. Kind
of
white.
Hey, I found Jack a funny guitar pick. It's made of rock.
Hey! Yeah, it's on the strings yellow.
I'm not sure it's close enough to the do that.
What?
I'm not sure it's
Whoa.
Close enough. I got the middle one. Wow. This is gonna work. Cost us zero. All right, y'all, we've got our bridge built. This is temporary. We're gonna see how it lasts. If it works good, then we may do some things to try to make it stronger. It's a little wobbly, but I don't think it's gonna break. And like I said, mainly it's just gonna be for us going back and forth to the garden, bringing vegetables and tomatoes and all that stuff back and forth across. So I think it's gonna be all right. If not, we didn't lose anything but maybe 20 minutes, and we'll figure some other plan out. I mean, I could always cut trees, buy some boards, and build a bridge. But, you know, why would I want to spend money if I don't have to? So if this works, we'll go with this.